Warning, these web clips feature stunts performed either by professionals or under the supervision of professionals. MTV and the producers must insist that no one attempt to reenact any stunt or activity performed on the site.
And this is the final countdown for our first mega event of 2016, CCL Supernova.
These fans are jam-packed in here, I'll tell you what. This is going to be a show to remember. And it's all shows to remember. You guys chose the stipulations, you guys chose the opponents for Supernova, so this was basically your show.
So if it sucks tomorrow, it's your fault. It's not just suck. I have confidence in you guys.
Yeah.
I believe you.
Exactly. If we didn't believe in you, we wouldn't have had you guys choose the stipulations.
This is true.
So yeah. We got Tammy in there.
Right. She'll be taking on Juliet Starling now for the contest. We're at the All-State Arena in Chicago, by the way.
Yes.
As we will be for the actual show tomorrow.
Here comes Juliet.
And now keep this in mind as you watch this final countdown show tonight. Any of these people could also be wrestling tomorrow.
Yes. It just depends on how the voting turned out.
Exactly.
Now, Juliet Starling could be teaming with Taylor Starr in the Women's Tag Team Championship. And, you know, of course, Juliana Fontana and Tammy, with their tag team, could be in that vote also. If they could have gotten the vote, but I'm not counting on it, but, you know, strange things are happening.
Without giving too much away before, I will tell you this about the women's tag team poll. It is the closest of the bunch.
Yeah, I'm guessing it is. I mean, you think about the women, the women's tag team championship picture. I mean, you have Cylectra, of course. You got Christy Montero, Wonder Woman. You got, of course, my wild card. If I'm thinking the wild card in the whole thing is Akira Yukimura and the Kid, to be honest with you. Because the role that Akira had been on, she tapped out both of the longest reigning tag team champions in the span of two shows.
Is this true?
So if she got the vote tomorrow, I would not be surprised by that one bit. And, oh, nice cross body there.
Like something in your fall. Got four matches for you on this hour and some change, but not too much change. Show. This is our final countdown. Plus, we'll run down the card for Supernova tomorrow. I mean, as much as we're allowed to run down the card. Oh, look at that.
Yeah, the only...
Crossfire by 10?
The only match that we know of that...
Oh! We know three. We know three of the nine.
Yeah, three of the nine that are confirmed. Everything else will be found out tomorrow night as the show happens too. And
but for those three matches, we don't know what the stipulations are. So
it's true.
Even that's a mystery.
Yeah, and those will be revealed, you know, as the night goes on. So
right.
You know, it's all up to tomorrow night and how they're voting it. Tammy
chopping the corner.
Doing a number on Juliet right now. Juliet Starling has all the talent in the world. That's no doubt about that. Champ has been adamant for years about how...
As have I, but she's...
She's got to do something. I don't know what, but she has to do something to just break out. And
no, I thought that one breakout win came... back at Fanarchy 2 a few years back, but...
Yeah, I mean... Juliet really hasn't found that one big moment that really could break her out into the break through the glass ceiling, if you want to use that cliche.
Right, and the challenge is so much deeper now.
Yeah, exactly. And plus with the end of CCL coming right around the corner,
right?
It's getting real close.
Clock's running.
Yeah.
Danny moonsault by Tammy gets a near fall.
I'd say about a year left.
Right.
You know, depending on how shows go and stuff, it'd be about a year. And, you know, Juliet doesn't have that much time. So if she wants to make a move, she's got to do something fast. Now Juliet. Julie go around.
Oh! Oh, Tammy caught her and power bombs her down.
Tammy's no slouch either.
She has been around quite a while. She's been in the game for quite some time. I've followed her career from almost since she broke in.
Yeah, I mean, if Tammy wasn't such a dumb C word that, you know, in chance words, then she probably would be in a better place in her career, to be honest with you. Because she's got talent, but she just can't put it all together. The writing isn't on the wall for her, you know.
Right. Boston grab as Tammy sits down and lets it go.
I guess she realized that she did enough damage, as you see, going for this nice head scissors hurricane rana takedown.
And Juliet with the presence of mind to roll out of the ring, and
Tammy gets
Juliet grab.
Tammy got out of the way there.
Oh!
Moved her leg.
She got out of the way of that, though.
Oh, for that. Jesus!
For that.
Like I said, Juliet, she doesn't have that much time left, and I guess she... Oh, look at this!
Look out!
Springboard Hurricane Rana to the outside.
Now,
Juliet, whoa. He might have slipped on that top rope there. Thought better of it. Decided not to go back after it, but that might have been a mistake as Tammy rolled her up with a sunset flip.
Slows it down. Does she have it? No. Juliet reverses it. Two, and Tammy kicks out.
And, ooh! Kicked right in the face.
Flash kicked her in the face. Wait a minute. Jackknife pin it. Oh, Juliet reverses it. Two, almost three.
Oh, man.
Didn't miss on that knee left.
Head scissor. Uh-oh.
Now that cheerleader background going to work. That handspring. Moves low and it's crossing double. She's got it.
Looks for both legs. And she's
got it. Countdown.
That's an important win for her right there. Like I said, she's just got to find that one thing that can break her out into the women's title picture. Because she's got that talent in her. She's got it in her to be a women's champion. She just has to do that one thing. She's got to find what that thing is and do it. Because time's running out for her. If she wants to be a champion, she's got to do it quick. But a big win for her will get her in the right direction here.
How's it going? Eddie Mack, me, you call him. This is Supernova Final Countdown, and we are just a day away from the show that you control. That, of course, being Supernova.
Yes. You're my second Supernova, I believe.
Yes, it'll be your second. It'll be for the champion, of course, number six for your show. And of course, you know, with the Supernova clause, that every champion has to face it tomorrow.
They
can't lose, or they won't get, they can't lose, because if they do, they will not get an immediate rematch.
Yeah, they go to the back of the line, essentially, so, you know, it's essential for these champions to understand they've got to get it done tonight, or if they don't, they're back in the line. And who knows when it'll be before they get another title shot.
Speaking of champions, one of only two Grand Slam champions in CCL history will make his long-awaited return to the ring tomorrow night. We first broke the news on Adrenaline Episode 83, in case you missed it. Here it is.
I got a question for you. What did you think was going to happen? The sun would rise and things would be changed? That we wouldn't come out? We'd stop running? We don't back down. We don't hide. You see, there will always be people like you. But there will always be people like us. We're not cities, buildings, or bodies. We're an idea. An idea of freedom, of liberty, of opportunity. So go ahead, give it your best shot. While our legs and bodies might give out, we never will. Because not all of us live in Boston, but Boston lives in us.
There's strong and there's Boston strong, and then there's Gregory Black and Boston strong. Grand Slam champion returns to the CAW Champions League tomorrow night.
I had a dream. Vast landscape. Where everybody came together into the crazy part is that it's real.
don't know. That promo for Pregnant Black Saturn, it just gives me goosebumps. I just want to say that. I just want to get that out of the way.
Oh, I'm pretty sure. And the thing about it is, like I said, I believe I said this on Pulse or Adrenaline, what kind of mindset is Gregory Black going to be in? Because remember, the winner of the match, no matter what stipulation it is, not only gets the hardcore title, but holds the future of that entire title, that entire division.
Right.
What was Gregory, is Gregory Black going to save it? Is he going to kill it? What is his mindset? Is he resentful? Is he grateful for coming back? We don't know. We haven't heard or seen him since this whole announcement was made. So we don't know what he's thinking, but I guess we'll find out tomorrow night.
And two people, I'm sure, keeping an eye on that match. It's the Hardcore Revolution. Hollywood Joseph Michaels, he's somewhere in the frame, but he's not the one competing in this match. He is. Damn. Man.
Yes.
And he has got a tough challenge ahead of him here at the Supernova Final Countdown.
To say that he's got a tough challenge would be a great understatement. Because Yeah.
Because as Champ would say, woo! He is about to face a grown ass man.
Yes, he is. Austin Bane.
The 6'8", 360 pound son. Yes, he's the son of that man right there. The Nightmare Blade Myers.
I said long ago about Austin Bane, I remember it clearly, when I said that this man could give Casey Gordon a run for his money. He can give anybody a run for his money, to be honest with you. Watching it right now, wherever you're watching it from, does not do it justice. If you look at this man up close, he is bigger than he appears on this screen you're looking at right now.
Vamp's got a lot of experience. He has been in the business for over a decade, but oh my goodness, man, I'm pretty sure he has not seen the likes of Austin Bane.
Oh, I'm pretty sure. Look at this man. Picking him up and slamming him into the mat like he is a little child. Nap time is now for you, sir, says Austin Bane.
Wait a minute, Vamp getting in the face of Blade Myers, and I don't think...
Vamp, no. Oh my god.
Okay, there's torture rack now.
Yeah, he's gonna break him in half. Oh, but Vamp, that experience coming into play.
DDT by...
That's what he's gotta use his speed as advantage here. He's gotta just take it to Bane.
I mean, Vamp can brawl with just about anybody, but
oh god! Yeah, brawling doesn't prepare you for getting clotheslined like that.
Sure, I'm clotheslined by Bane, and Vamp gets a shoulder up, and oh, right down Vamp goes.
To be honest, Vamp is tough as hell. There's no doubt about that.
He is.
But Austin Bane is a completely different man. He's a completely different animal. Look at this. Caving his chest in with those knees. And Matos... No.
Oh!
Yep, Matos' jaw just got broken.
Oh!
I will say that now.
Austin's jaw might have also gotten broken there. And
to be honest, it would take a lot for that to happen. Oh, what? Oh, you... What?
Wow!
What?
Hey, military, bro! Oh!
Wow! He's crazy and demented, but
he's also strong.
Yeah.
Oh!
If that didn't prove it, look at Matos arguing with the referee because Vamp is getting thrown around like a rag doll. Now Blade saying, "You no, no lying down. Get up." And now Matos trying to run in, but
oh,
there's Matos. Matos doing the dumbest thing he can do, or the second dumbest thing he's done all night.
And suddenly we have two fights going on at once.
Yeah, I think this one in here is almost over now.
What a shock slam!
I mean, let's be fair.
Leg hook, Tammy.
Close.
Wow.
Let's be fair here. Both Vamp and Matos are former world champions.
Right.
They know how to get it done in the ring. They are talented. Let's be honest.
They know every trick in the business, as they say.
Yeah, but then again, you look at this. He's getting his face stretched out by Austin Bane right now. He literally has his big paw-like hands, his bare paw-like hands over Vamp's face and pulling. I don't know what to call that other than painful.
Painful is...
And Blade and Matos are still fighting out here. You can't see it, but on the right-hand part of the screen, they are still fighting.
Man, but I'm not sure if it was going for the V-cutter, but it gets counted there.
Oh,
in the
gosh. And Bane...
Brush the legs. Oh, my...
He's dead.
Get the medic for Vamp.
He is dead. He is dead.
I'll say it again. Austin Bane's a grown-ass man.
And that grown-ass man just speared the hell out of Vamp so hard, I'm surprised he didn't go halfway through the floor. I've seen some spears in my time, but that... Look at it. Good God. I've seen some spears before, but that is up there. I don't even think Vamp even knows what happened. All he knows is he's probably got a broken rib right now. That's about it.
Multiple broken
probably.
Ribs. I tell you what, the strength combined with the mindset of Clayton Myers in his ear.
This man's going places.
Yes, he is.
He is going places. If not in CCL and virtual wrestling, period, he is going places. This is a grown-ass man.
Are you fucking kidding me, Shane? From the brute savagery of the likes of Austin Bane and Vamp, we go to the beauties, the bombshells of the CAW Champions League. And how about this? We have two former women's champions about to face off here.
Nice.
I know it's hard to focus on these laws. I'm with you. I get it, but
hey. I have a girlfriend, so I can't say anything. I will admit, they're beautiful, but I just can't be doing all that stuff. I get slapped when I get home.
Emily did that.
Yes.
Here's Emma, the next killer. She'll be taking on Pyra now. These two have been in the history.
Hey, she's taking on Pyra?
She's taking on Pyra.
Oh, jeez. In the mood that Pyra is in, And we'll get to that in a moment, but go ahead, Eddie.
Like I said, these two have been officially during the holiday Gold Rush tournament. Pyra was the cause of Samus getting eliminated from the tournament.
Yeah.
When Samus' partner Laura Croft was attacked by Pyra, she went to check. She ran back to check on her, and not only did Pyra attacked her. Pyra sent Samus. On those electrical box things.
Yeah. I mean, good thing they had backup generators. But this is different. And this is a different situation for, and it's not even Samus' fault. It really isn't. I don't think Samus even realizes exactly what is going on right now. But I will allow Eddie to explain it if you have not seen what's going down yet.
Yeah, Pyra said quite the issue with Logan Rankoff as of late.
Yeah, to say quite the problem would be an understatement. It has been a war. This has been a war between those two women.
I tell you what, if Pyra's not careful, if Pyra's not focused, she could get caught and she could get upset here.
Yeah, exactly, because Pyra has a lot on her mind right now. I'm pretty sure.
Oh
God!
I'm pretty sure Samus doesn't care about all that.
No, she doesn't. But for those of you who don't know what is going on, and I'm pretty sure by now it's out. I'm pretty sure the episode is out. Episode 22 of Wildcats.
Yeah, it's out.
It is out. A big announcement was made. The concerning Pyra. Okay. The next Wildcats mega event, Wildcats Death and Defiance, aka DX Squad.
Mm-hmm.
Pyra, Morgan Rancroft, and Amber Stevens will be in a triple threat match. But that's not the big story here. The big
I'll get to that.
Yeah, go ahead, Eddie.
Once that match, hey, come on now. Dean pulling that AJ Myers. Oh,
oh, Jesus!
You always have to be wary of that when you take on Sam.
Mm-hmm. But, you know, just to point out, Eddie, before you say that, I will say this. It's not just after. It's before and after the match. But go ahead.
Right. Once that match, oh, my God.
Like,
Sam's on a different level this evening, I'll tell you what.
Mm-hmm. Well, she knows who she's getting in the ring with.
Right. And, again, I should point this out. They could be wrestling again tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. In the, either the tag title or the women's title. Good Lord, Pyra.
In Sam's case, both.
Yeah.
Hell, it could be in Pyra's case.
Probably. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it could. Because, you know, if there are enough votes, I mean, there was an other option for the... Oh, my God!
Again.
For the women's... There was an other option for the women's tag title.
Yeah, there was. So Pyra could be in there. Oh, my goodness. But, let me get to what Eddie was going to say.
Yes.
Or at least half of it.
Yeah, I got it from
you. Oh, okay. Okay, go ahead. That's fine.
As Pyra's got a modified camel clutch there going. Once that triple threat match concludes, neither Pyra nor Morgan Rancroft can touch each other until the mega event following that one, that is DCA Redemption. That match will be a free-fall Hell in a Cell match.
Yes.
If they put their hands on one another before that match, regardless of who starts it, they're both gone for 6 months.
And it doesn't matter if it's in CCL or DCL.
Or for that matter, anywhere in the world.
Anywhere. 6 months gone from both companies. I don't know how they're going to do it. But before DXD and after it, until Redemption, they cannot touch each other. And that, I can't see that happening. But what's even crazier is that Envy put them in a free fall Hell in a Cell match. I've seen the first two. They have not been pretty.
The career of General Manager Dallas, her career ended in the first ever such match.
Yeah. You got to... I guess Pyra's trying to show Morgan that she can be athletic too. But you gotta wonder what Dallas thinks about it though. Dallas was in that match. You gotta wonder what she feels about Envy putting probably two of the top women stars in CCL.
I guess the CCL, all of virtual,
all of virtual wrestling. Yeah, you're right. And all of virtual wrestling in a match that could literally end both of their careers.
I should also point this out. It wasn't only Dallas' career that ended in that match. Sergeant Clemens, her opponent's career, ended in that match.
Yeah. Exactly. So, you know.
And my name tonight is... Oh, she
barely made it.
Barely makes it, and Pyra, I think, was not aware of that until now.
Yeah, Pyra needs to stay focused here as Shazine is really upset. Shazine has got to be upset too, because her main women's show. That may have been a mistake though. She caught Pyra, but she grazed her. And Pyra with the bear hug. But realizing that it was on the floor, she let it go. She can't win it out there.
But remember, they're not bound by the mega event rules here on Final Countdown, so.
Yeah, I'm moving.
No.
Yeah, I'm moving. Eddie, you there? Yeah, I think so. Trying to get the audio back, ladies and gentlemen, as you see Samus trying to come back now. In the corner, off the ropes. Big crossbody. Trying to get Eddie hooked up here. He's a human being. Come on, hook him up.
I'm good.
Samus now.
Samus with the zero mission neck breaker.
Samus could pull it off here. He's got to take advantage right now.
Away from a huge hustle! But no water isn't pulled for the crystal flash.
And there's the bear hug again. A move that put so many bombshells away, put Wonder Woman away for at least 3 and 4 months. Crowd trying to will Samus into it, but Samus is fading here.
I'm not sure if Samus might be out still.
Yeah, she probably is.
Yeah,
it's over. Yeah, it's over.
This is over. Samus becomes another victim of the monstrous power.
I'm telling you what, Pyra is on another level right now. She's been on another level since the big one. She's been pissed since the big one. And that was months ago.
6 months?
6 months. She's been obsessed with ending Morgan Raycroft. I'm not going to say that Indy made the right call in putting them in a match like a three-fall Hell in a Cell, but if there's any match that can finally end it between those two, it's that one. And who knows, Pyra could be CCL Women's Champion by then if she gets the vote.
That is true.
But for now,
I'll tell you what, if Samus can beat tomorrow night, she will be at a severe disadvantage.
Yes, she will, but Pyra is going to go in with all the momentum.
Has got this in the bag. He's gonna fucking kill you.
Oh my god, he got him.
Oh my goodness, did you see that? He's got him up. Wait a minute. Jackhammer! A jackhammer! He's done it!
Now he's got the belt and Cyrax is getting up. Cyrax now trying to run back. Trying to run back. It is too late now.
Oh yeah. Oh, I'm getting another Styles Clash. Oh my god.
What's this? Wait a minute. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Not like this. But you know, don't do this. Come on. You're going to break that man's back. No.
Yeah, you can't see a doctor. This is not possible.
No, shit. No.
Oh my god. Oh my god. of Ben with a 7-foot slam.
But it is time. Here we go. Ice cream somersault. Sabre retains the SA Women's Championship.
Green Lantern is going for it. He's going for it. Brightest day. Is he going to get the underdog win? 1, 2, 3. And he wins it.
Going, everybody, Sandy Mac along with D Wall. And here's the card for CCL Supernova. But first, the theme. You're listening to Nothing to Lose by Ray and Anita. It is available where music is sold and on streaming services
right now,
everywhere.
Right now.
Women's Tag Team Titles will be on the line as one person defends against the challenger of her choosing.
And guys, the voting was real close. Real close.
Was. The national title will be on the line as the Aristocrat and self-proclaimed descendant of Julius Caesar, Daryl Augustine, defends against the challenger of Virtue.
He better be focused.
Augustine won the title by surprise a few months ago. We'll see if he can hold on to it. And it's matched to be determined. Michael Hyman will take on Bradley Reynolds.
Bradley Reynolds has been on a roll since breaking away from Hyman, but Hyman wants to show him that he was nothing without him.
The tag title will be on the line as Big Money defends against the challenger that you select.
Big Money, they don't care who it is. They just want the cash checks and breaknecks to keep those tag team titles around their waist. Can they do it, though? We'll find out.
The Bombshells title will be defended in a match to be determined as Ashley Knight takes on her sister-in-law and the former champion.
As Envy says, and it still haunts me, these words, that the fate of Cleopatra is in your hands. And what was that deal that Envy had with Ashley? There's a lot of speculation going into this one.
In a match to be determined, the duelist will take on the team of the Fortune Over Show.
I'm glad we're not going to be in a skybox for this event, because these two teams are going to tear each other apart. That arena, the arena may not last through the night with those two.
The hardcore title will be on the line and the future of the division as Sherman Samson defends against G.J. Wizard and the returning Gregory Black.
And what is Gregory Black's mindset? Will he want to save the division? Will he want to kill it? Can Samson retain? Can C.J. Wizard? Right, we know his right objective. Now, right now, what's going to happen? Right now, we don't know. Right now, we'll find out tomorrow night.
Women's title will be on the line as Nadi defends against the challenger of your
choosing. It's gonna be pretty epic defending the title for Nadi, but with it being an unknown until the match starts, Nadi's gotta stay focused on retaining the title.
And the war heavyweight title will be on the line as the raging redneck Ray Geddes defends against the challenger of your choosing.
And remember what the haunting words from a suspended Chris Knight: if he did not get the vote, he will be at Supernova and make sure that Ray Geddes does not leave as the world heavyweight champion.
See you tomorrow night for Supernova.
I'm never gonna rest if it's less than the gold. You can see me on the throne, sharing medals with the bone. I own, I show, I stay legit. Try to take me, there's no way I'm ever gonna quit. This is it, I'm always on, ready for a battle. Doesn't matter if it's Beijing or back in Seattle. I'm amphibious, I live this, the world is my pool. While I'm backstroke and chilling, you're just choking like a fool. Stay cool, make a choice, you can swim or drown. I'll tell you right now, go against me, you're going down. This is what it looks like, being the best. What it looks like to be a cut up of the rest. What it looks like, being the best. What it looks like to be a cut up of the rest. What it looks like, being the best. What it looks like to be a cut up of the rest. What it looks like, being the best. What it looks like to be a cut up of the rest. Nothing is free but see me.
And we come down to our feature bounce of this final countdown, and it is not one return, but two. Superwoman World Champion is about to face off here. First up, the Alpha Jock, EJ Logan, the first ever Grand Slam champion in CCL history.
This is going to be a great match here. As always, when you got two Thunder World Champions facing off.
Scott, your boy in the booth, nigga!
Matter of fact, I don't want you in my
chair. About to take you off against you.
Godzilla bankroll, stones from Cillion. Yo, I ain't got it all. That means I'm barely home. Trailblazer, stay ballin' with vengeance. My heart's is crafty dogs. Why y'all stuck on Laffy Taffy wondering? Yeah, how did y'all niggas get past me? I've been doing this before Nas dropped it nasty. My waddles, I did them up. Them bricks, I sent them up. My raps, I bit them up. For that, now stick them up. 10-4, good buddy Tone got his money up. Worth million, still back your bitch looking for me. Why y'all staring at the angel with death? Lying, lying, pants on fire, you burning up like David Koresh. This is architect music, verbal street opera, proper tech man. Fluent, got the projects booming indeed. I ran through the tunnel, terrorized speed. That's when I was still in the jungle, slinging that D.
Get out my face, don't need no, you got no more. Don't need no heads, been messing up my corner. And they're banging that bad look on face before I knock it off. Hey, fool, you ready for another beat? You should have never came back.
Fighting the opposition with the Alpha Jock is man to man. Money in the bank, more than one. Nathan out.
To be fair, this is going to be my first time I've seen Nathan House actually calling a one-on-one match of Nathan House. And I've seen a lot of his previous work, and he is one of the best talents that CCL's ever had in its entire history. And like I said, this is going to be one of those matches that honestly could have been on Supernova if it wasn't for the fact that it was a fan-only show, to be honest. This could headline any mega event anywhere.
I have 15 minutes, as a matter of fact. Okay. To the days of the movement when DJ Logan was a part of that group and Nathan House was a part of the group trying to stave it off, and here we go.
These two, I'm pretty sure over the years have grown a mutual respect for each other. I'm pretty sure that this is going to be one of those classic matches that we're going to be talking about for quite a while.
Logan at this very event just over a couple of years ago. In fact, I would say close to 2.5 years ago. It was definitely over 2 years ago that Logan was within an eyelash of becoming the CCL World Champion in the second ever Elimination Chamber match. All in CCL history, he won the first.
I believe that was in 2013.
2013 was the second, and 2011, Black Friday, was the first.
Yeah, CJ Logan became, was in an eyelash for winning the belt when back when Gregory Black was the world champion. Nathan House, former Mr. Money in the Bank,
won the first ever 40, won the first 40-man Money in the Bank Royal Rumble match. That was back at Ali Havoc 2. He won it entering number 24. Would hold on to it for just over 11 months, cashing in on an episode of CCL Revolution back in November. I'm sorry, that was the first one he cashed in. The second one, he actually held on to it for the entire year until Ali Havoc 3, but was unsuccessful in taking the championship from Bret Hart that night.
And both of these men, they gotta know that with CCL coming to an end, I'm pretty sure both of these men want to be back in the world title picture, because after this event is over, it's gonna be a fresh, clean slate. Let's put it fair. No matter what happens, whether if Ray retains or if somebody else, whoever gets voted in, becomes the new champion, it's gonna be a fresh slate. So anybody could literally walk in the door and earn a world title opportunity. And with CCL, like you said,
Oh, power slam by Logan. Also something else to keep in mind. Guess what's coming up like almost right after Supernova?
Yeah.
Go ahead, check your calendar. I'll wait. Yeah, if you notice, the next month on the calendar is March. And you know what that means.
March Madness.
Oh
good
Jesus.
Lord.
I love it.
And I'm pretty sure the brackets for those March Madness will most likely be announced at Supernova.
Not a Supernova.
Ah. Okay.
But we will have some information on it on the first adrenaline following.
Okay. I was just guessing because, we're like a week away from March, so right. I was just,
Right.
But it's up. I'm curious to see who's going to be in the brackets this year, because you got so many people who've stepped up.
Oh!
Ooh. We have so many people who've stepped up since the last March Madness.
Right.
And oh, look,
look out!
A man that size. You'd think a man that size and that height would not be able to jump that high, but you forget that this is the Alpha Jock we're talking about.
6'6", 260 pounds, a former multi-sport athlete at the University of Minnesota.
Yeah. He's one of those guys, you look at him and you say, he can't jump over that top rope. He just did. And Nathan House knows Logan too well at this point. Big right hand.
Big right hand.
Yeah, but Logan right back up.
I think Nathan was setting up to flip this house, but...
Ooh, they close.
Close line by House. Logan goes for one and misses. Back body drop counter. And a spine buster.
And, ooh! Logan countered whatever he was going for and a big shoulder tackle. DJ Logan, I remember a Future Shock a few years ago took then DCA World Champion Atlas Jones to the limit. So, good lord!
My God, what is awful? Two men.
Oh,
oh, gets the shoulder up.
House coming back now with Lupe's press. I was there that night when that match happened. That was the first time that the DCA World Championship was defended at another event. And I saw exactly what CJ Logan was made of. Is that, it's not like I didn't think he didn't have talent. Because I know he has talent. But he really stepped it up that night. And cover here too. It showed me exactly what kind of talent CJ Logan was. And still is.
Logan was all taken out by CJ Wizard on the first adrenaline of the new season. And I may be wrong. He might have an eye on that hardcore title match tonight.
I'm pretty sure.
Tomorrow night, I should say.
Tomorrow night. I'm pretty sure.
He might.
Uh-oh. And look at... Good!
Whoa!
Had a bit of lights right there.
House was barely touching the lights, are you kidding?
Yeah.
Legends hooked and House up at two.
That's the power of DJ Logan. That combination of power and speed and agility.
Same could be said for Nathan.
Yeah. Nathan House is no slouch. Uh-oh.
Oh, yes.
Now the Illinois crab here. We would call it the Boston crab, but if Gregory Black hits it tomorrow night, then we'll call it the Boston crab because we can get away with it.
Right. But that, of course, will depend on if he has the opportunity to...
Yeah, it is a triple threat match.
And, oh!
Logan.
Logan gets the ropes.
That's the advantage of that height that Logan has, and oh, goodness.
Logan at 6'6", he's actually for sure the true House is 6'9".
Ah, but the reach, though, reach advantage is in Logan's favor.
It is. That's surprising, because House usually has the reach advantage over most anybody. But hey, schoolboy!
Oh.
Logan gets the ropes, and again, the advantage of having that being 6'6", and having a long reach.
Mm-hmm.
Not that he didn't have to make much of an effort on that reach, but...
Ooh!
I think it's... I think he was thinking about that people's elbow.
I'm pretty sure. He was going for it, but Logan, with that experience, he knew him too well. Got right up. Two. And now,
Schoolboy. Two. And, this time Logan had to get his shoulder up.
Yeah, he didn't have the advantage of the ropes right there. And House telling him to bring it, and Logan just did with an axe handle to the face.
It's been brought, sir.
Uh-oh, look at this.
Oh, yes, Paul Pagas throws it down. Does he have it? He does.
No. Again, that agility of Logan. And look at this.
Logan up to the kidneys, and he's doing push-ups.
Hey, Logan, he gloats when he knows he's in control.
Not quite in control there. Schoolboy is Logan again able to get the ropes.
And then again, Alpha Jocks do tend to gloat a bit.
Yeah, this is true.
I don't fault him for that. Look, and now Logan's feeling it. He's got to put Nathan away now.
Come on, find shoulder blocks in. Hip toss count.
Dropped him with that hip toss. Now House. Off the ropes here. Oh! Ran into that big frame of Logan.
Oh!
Good.
Think House might have won for Papa, but we will never know now.
Yeah, because Logan just with those pair of shoulder blocks. Swinging and miss. Nice. Dropped him. Now, Logan. Maybe looking for touchdown, Logan. No.
I think Nathan saw that too.
Uh-oh, wait a minute.
Let the Southies get it!
Gotta put him away now, though. Can't waste time. Oh, but wait a minute.
Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the most electrifying move in all of virtual wrestling. The People's Elbow.
Nathan House dropped him with the People's Elbow. And House going in for the pin. One, two, and no.
Oh!
Like I said, he might have taken a little bit too much time. People's...
Oh, he's going for it again.
No. Went for the... Looking like a rock bottom there. Got it. Got it. What a win for Logan.
I would like to
Definitely. going for the lifted house again. And got countered a touchdown, Logan. That was a great.
Logan in his first match in nearly 6 months. Gets the win.
Might be the victory to propel him back up to possibly a world title shot.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching the final countdown, and we will see you tomorrow night.
See you for Supernova, guys. It's gonna be a good one.